MAPSE and TAPSE, or mitral annular plane excursion and tricuspid annular plane systolic excursion. As we know, during systolic, the lung axis becomes short. So lung axis shortening happen in during systolic. In another word, at the base of the heart during systole, move forward toward the apex. That is, we called it excursion. If we measure this amount of the displacement of the base of the heart toward the apex, indirectly we can have a good indicator for left ventricular and right ventricular systolic function. This type of the measurement is valuable only if the patient doesn't have prominent valvular calcification on a heart surgery. Let's go first with the TAPSE. For TAPSE, we have to get a good four-chamber view and put cursor to the lateral annulus of tricuspid valve here, as you see, and then do M-mode. In many, the important for this type of study is that you put the cursor the way that is parallel to the movement annulus. If you notice here, the cursor line is this way. I put it lateral annulus of tricuspid, and the annulus is moved almost parallel, but not exactly. If it's not parallel completely, go a little off axis and try find an image that give you that option. So if you find that I'm a little off axis here, but my here in this way, I am completely almost parallel to the my tricuspid annulus, lateral annulus plane, and then I hit the M mode, and I will get such image very nice. For measuring TAPSE, I have to find exactly how much that part of the cursor that crossed the tricuspid lateral plane, how much go forward. It's very easy if you measure. That is the lowest spot that had, and then I go and find how much it goes higher. So one here, here, and the another one, if you use cal is more better. I can measure, put it here, and automatically machine show me here 2.3, or I have it this horizontal line exactly, the maximum point is here, so I can do the same way here, or no, this way, this height, this amount of going down and up, this distance, it give me excursion, how much that spot of annulus tricuspid valve move forward, almost 2.3. So this is my TAPSE. Normal in the TAPSE is equal or more than 18 millimeter. If it's below the 15, it's almost it indicate we have some kind of right ventricular systolic function problem. For the MAPSE, we have three spot for doing for MAPSE: medial, lateral, or anterior annulus. For that matter, we go for four chamber, find a four chamber, a nice four chamber, and then do it first for the medial annulus. Put cursor at the exactly medial annulus, and then hit the M mode, and you will see this image, and you then measure the amount of excursion that in this case, if I measure it, is from here, the minimum, the lowest part, to the highest part here. As you see here, and then both of them will be correct, just as long as you measure it exactly how much that spot goes forward to the apex. Here, there you go. And for lateral, you do put your cursor on lateral wall at annulus and try get it parallel to the movement of the annulus here, as you see lateral, and then hit the end mode and then repeat it and measure the same for how much it goes up from that spine. Normal for this measurement is a 12 to 15 millimeter. Even the medial annulus excursion is less than 8, usually it represents systolic ejection fraction less than 50%. And for the anterior annulus excursion, you can go for apical two-chamber and put the anterior annulus on the mitral valve and then hit the M mode and you get it that one too.